Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. In today's video, I am going to show you how to create a virtual machine, also known as VM, in Windows 11. A virtual machine allows you to run another operating system within your current Windows environment. This is a fantastic tool for testing new software, so follow the step to create your own virtual machine. So there are a couple of things to check before creating your virtual machine. Okay. We need to make sure virtualization is enabled in the BIOS. If you are not sure how to enable it, don't worry, I have already made a detailed step-by-step guide in a separate video. Just click on the I button above to check it out and follow to enable virtualization on your system. Once you have done, come back here and we'll continue with setting up with your virtual machine in Windows 11. Okay. After that, you will need to enable Hyper-V, which is a Microsoft built-in virtualization tool for creating virtual machine. Microsoft has included it as a free Windows component. To enable this, go to the Start menu and type Windows Features. And here you will find Turn Windows Features On and Off. Just click on this. In the windows that opens, scroll down and find Hyper-V. Check the box next to it and any additional features you might need, like Virtual Machine Management Tool. Okay. Then click OK. And follow any on-screen prompts to restart your PC if necessary. Now that Hyper-V is installed, let's set up our first virtual machine. Okay, so for that, open the Start menu and here you need to search for Hyper-V Manager and launch the application. Once you are in the Hyper-V Manager, in the right-hand side, action part under your computer name, click New and then Virtual Machine. This will launch the new virtual machine wizard. This wizard will guide you through several steps. Okay. So first, before you begin, if you want, you can read the information and click Next. Now specify name and location. Here, give your virtual machine a name. Suppose I am going to name it Tech VM. And you will also need to choose where you'd like to store your virtual machine. Okay. By default, Windows will select the local C drive, your Windows installation drive. If you are lacking in space, you can change this to use a separate disk or drive. Okay. Then click on Next. Specify generation. Here, you need to choose the generation of this virtual machine. If you want to use legacy or older system, then you can select generation 1. Otherwise, you can choose generation 2 for most modern operating system. Okay. Then click Next. Now in Assign Memory, the next step is to assign memory or RAM to your virtual machine. That means the amount you assign depends on the operating system you plan to install and your system's available resource. Okay. It is recommended that you allocate at least 2 GB of your operating system to run smoothly. Then click on Next. Configure networking. In the next step, you must configure the virtual machine's network. Select default switch from the drop-down next to connection. Click Next once you have selected an options. Now connect virtual hard drive. Here you need to create a new virtual hard disk where you want to install new operating system, or you can use an existing one if you have any. Okay. And you can also define the size of this hard disk. I will keep it as it is, then click Next. Installation option. Choose install an operating system from a bootable image file and click browse to find your ISO file. You can see this is my Windows 11 ISO file. You need to create your own ISO file. If you don't know how to create an ISO file, I had already made one video on that. You can check that video in the description below. Okay. You can also use the installation files from a CD, DVD, USB drive or another storage location if you want. Click Next after selecting the desired option. Now finally, in the summary, review the configuration details and click Finish to begin creating the virtual machine. After the installation, your virtual machine will be ready to use via Hyper-V Manager. And here you can see that the new virtual machine name appear over here. Now we need to install the operating system on your new virtual machine. For that, you just need to right click on your new virtual machine and select connect. Then follow the on-screen instruction to install your operating system. This process will vary depending on which operating system you are installing. After installation is successful, you should be able to use the installed operating system in your virtual machine, like any other PC. You can also test anything you like without affecting your primary operating system. And that's it. This is how you can set up a virtual machine in Windows 11. If you found this tutorial helpful, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the bell icon to get notified of our latest video. If you have any question or run into any issue, drop a comment below. Thanks for watching.